All right, let's start with a brief introduction to H2O Wave and its core concepts before we start building our first Wave app. So, what is Wave? Wave is an open source software stack for building attractive, low latency browser-based applications and dashboards without the need for using HTML, JavaScript, or CSS. It can be written in Python, and you are able to build and deploy real-time analytics with dramatically less effort. It is incredibly easy and intuitive to learn and use. In fact, I actually built my first Wave app within literal weeks upon being introduced to Wave. Some of its advanced functionality, which we will go over later in this course series, is that Wave has the ability to easily integrate with AutoML from H2O AI Cloud, as well as Enterprise H2O GPT. So, what can you use Wave for? It really helps one to capture visualizations, data analyses, and graphics from multiple sources and broadcast them in a rapid manner. You can prototype business-facing AI applications, such as creating a customer churn prediction app, to a chatbot, to live information displays, to even collaborative apps like whiteboards. You can also use Wave for non-real-time apps as well. For example, if you just want to show some simple charts and numbers for your data science project, Wave can serve as just the right tool for you. So there are three components of H2O Wave. First is the application code, then the content server, and finally the browser-based client. The application code is what we will be writing together later on to build a Wave app. It is usually written in Python, and we'll be using the H2O Wave package. This application code pretty much determines how to handle user events or app logic and sends information to the content server. Then, the content server is a small static binary executable that can run anywhere from your local machine to the cloud to even a Raspberry Pi. It stores your site contents and pretty much transmits content changes to your browser so that your app is fully updated in real time with your latest code. Also, it takes any browser-based events from your end users and sends those back to the apps. As for a final component, the browser-based client, this is how your end user is going to be interacting with your content. They can use any browser they want, whether that's Safari or Chrome or Firefox, and it's a place where you're hosting the user interface and sending user events to the content server. Now that we've covered some of the basics of what H2O Wave is all about, let's do a quick tour of our Wave website before jumping into further details.
All you have to do is type wave.h2o.ai to access the website. Here you can find lots of details about Wave and how you can use it to build your own customized application. As soon as you hit the Get Started button, you will learn more about what Wave is, how you can install it, as well as some beginner tutorials. Note that we will be covering in our next video on how to install and set up Wave, and in a later course, we will build together our first Wave app. So definitely stay tuned for that. In this website, you can also take a look at this guide where you can take a deep dive into how Wave works. For example, you can take a look at examples of Wave scripts and a structure of a Wave app. In this course series, we will practically show you how these work by building a Wave app together. But if you would like to revisit these concepts, this website is certainly the place to go. Once you click on the Widgets tab, you can see that Wave already has tons of ready-to-use components for you. For example, if you want to create a stat bar, you can see the exact Wave script by clicking on it to build it into your app. Upon clicking the Examples tab, you can look at the variety of apps and its code and essentially use it as a point of reference when you're writing your Wave scripts. For example, if you'd like to create a chatbot, you can easily go into the search bar and type up chatbot and look at the code here and reference it. We also recommend that you take a look at the API tab to get more information about the H2O Wave package. If you want to see what's new in Wave, simply click on the blog tab. And if you'd like to access the online community, you can certainly go on this discuss tab and point out any questions that you have. Finally, upon clicking the Enterprise tab, you could look into further documentation of the AI App Store. We hope that this resource is very helpful for you, and in our opinion, it's the number one resource for you to build your AI app successfully.